everybody. I'm Federici from University dell'Aquila, and now I will present seismic detector we design specifically for the use in wireless sensor node targeting structural health monitoring application. And in this presentation, I will briefly talk about the problematic related to the implementation of a structural health monitoring system, and I will show an experimental case study for the long period monitor of an heritage infrastructure in l'Aquila. I will motivate the need for seismic detector circuit, and I will show some results we obtained using experimental data from the mentioned setup. So structural health monitoring is really a vast set of techniques for the short-term and long-term characterization of the behavior of a structure, and able to assess the state of the structure and to guarantee and estimate a safety level for people and users of the structure. Structural monitoring programs are very important in the fact that they can ensure the reliability of the infrastructure. And for example, here I can cite the case of the 2009 L'Aquila earthquake that struck my city, L'Aquila, and that caused damage to 11,000 buildings in the city, in most cases because the actual state of the structures was not known prior to the event. Among the various techniques that we can consider, the monitor of a seismic event is very important, specifically in earthquake-prone areas. And this is just because two main motivations. The first one, the most known, most intuitive, is that seismic detection can be the base for early warning strategies. So just to put in place prevention strategies before in the immediate aftermath that a single earthquake event occurs. The second reason that is less intuitive is that using seismic detection is possible to proceed to the identification of building. And to talk about this, I will show our test data setup that is the long-term monitoring of a church in L'Aquila. This is the Basilica Santa Maria di Collemaggio, the most important church in the city of L'Aquila. This church was strongly damaged by the earthquake that occurred 5 years ago. The earthquake caused the collapse of part of the structure. After the earthquake, we deployed a wireless sensor network in the church for the structural monitoring over a 3 year period. And for this structural monitoring, we employed a commercial node, that is MEMC-CHEMO2, and also some custom node we developed. One is the West mode that I presented last year in the sensor conference. This is actually the deployment of this wireless sensor network inside the church. We have basically accelerometer sensor, crack meter sensor, and inclinometer sensor. This is basically our monitoring system, and it is running continuously since 3 years. What we noticed studying this monitoring system is that for a specific kind of structure, and specifically for heritage infrastructure, that is a specific behavior related to the model behavior of the structure. Specifically, when you consider the vibration mode of the structure, you can notice that a large number of modes are involved in vibration, and this causes basically a small level of vibration inside the structure. And measuring this small level of vibration using let's say a general purpose and low performance accelerometer is very difficult. So for this specific kind of structure, you cannot use the usual and diffuse civil engineering analysis techniques for structural identification. So what we do is to use instead the seismic excitation of the structure just to proceed to a model identification of the structure. So we need an efficient seismic detector just for two main reasons. This detector can be the base for early warning strategies, and they also can be used for the identification of large heritage structures. What we want to implement is an efficient seismic detector that can be integrated inside a wireless sensor node and serve as the base for these two different tasks. In the Colarieti setup, we have one part of the network that is a mains power, wall power, and so is able to continuously operate over the time. This is not the normal behavior of a wireless sensor node that is usually battery power and so relies on duty cycling technique. So for the majority of the time, it stays in its standby state and is not operating. What we want to introduce is a small separate unit that is able to continuously process the seismic data and to efficiently detect possible seismic events. The detector we implemented is a detector based on the Walsh transform. What is the reason behind this choice? Basically, is that for detection of seismic events, you can basically rely on the study of energy variation for the acceleration signal. And two main strategies are the analysis of time domain series, for example, with the comparison of a short-term average with a long-term average, or the frequency analysis. This approach, based on the Walsh transform, is a sort of frequency analysis approach, but it is based on the use of Walsh transform instead of Fourier transform. And Walsh transforms are way more simple than Fourier coefficient, basically, because Walsh coefficients can only assume the plus one or minus one value. This is basically the algorithm we implemented, and is derived from a paper from 1983 by Gofford and Lehrin. And Walsh coefficients are basically used to derive a synthetic index S that is representative of the seismic behavior of the signal inside a certain temporal window. So for a certain segment of this acceleration track, you can calculate the Walsh transform and then accumulate the calculated Walsh coefficient in order to derive this X index. The reason why we choose this algorithm is that it is very simple to directly map the algorithm on the hardware blocks, basically. So you can implement basically two main blocks. One analysis block that is tailored to the calculation of the Walsh transform of the acquired sample, and a detection block that basically is able to derive the S index and to basically detect the seismic events by comparing the S index with a specific threshold that is in this simple implementation initialized by an external master unit. For what concerns the analysis module, I say that the implementation of Walsh transform is very simple. This is true because it's possible to easily derive in a digital form the Walsh coefficient based on the relation between the Walsh function and the Rademacher function, and it's a notorious literature result that the Rademacher function can be easily generated in digital form relying on a simple counter and decoder logic. So basically using these two module, an analysis module that is able to derive the Walsh transform, then accumulating the calculated Walsh coefficient and comparing the Walsh coefficient with a specified ratio, we can basically detect the seismic events. We implemented the prototype of this detector on a FPGA and test its behavior both in a simulation and with a practical test. We use a series of data we acquired from the structural monitoring of the Basilica Santa Maria di Collemaggio I mentioned before. Here I report some of the most significant cases of earthquake that occurred for the Basilica since we started our monitoring. And as I said, we will be able to use this data also for the model identification of the structure. So in this graph, you can see the three model shapes of the basilica is identified relying on the seismic data series. This result will be published in the next future. And here I detailed basically the behavior of this detector in the case of seismic events. The importance of this detector is that it is able to detect seismic events even if they are of very weak amplitude and they are basically immersed in the noise, in the background noise introduced by the sensor. So here I highlighted the seismic event that occurred in one of the cases that are reported in the previous slide, and we can see how the seismic detector is able to amplify and evidence the events. This is the S index series, and this is basically the result we obtaining using raw ADC data acquired from the Cold Module setup. As we said, we implemented this block also in FPGA, and the implementation is very simple because to implement the Walsh transform, basically you need only a counter, an adder, and some decoding logic. And for the implementation of FPGA, about the 1% of total area of Spartan 3 FPGA is occupied. That corresponds to about 300 slides on the slices on the FPGA. We are studying and developing furtherly this prototype, and in the next future we want to integrate directly this FPGA prototype inside a real world sensor node, so moving beyond the simple simulation, and maybe put in place some laboratory and on-field testing. This will be the next work. Also, a brief glance to another activity we are going to start. The Colarieti setup is going to terminate basically because the church is going, will undergo to restoration. But we will extend our central monitoring studies in a project that has the main goal of implementing a smart city framework in the city of L'Aquila. This framework will include also structural health monitoring service, and maybe it will be an open framework, also an open testbed for other external contributions. So I would like to mention also this fact.